welcome. I'm Dan Klein here at the Kerman Grotto, kind of the de facto Democratic headquarters, with three candidates on the Democratic side of the aisle looking to get a big win tonight. We already spoke with VO County Sheriff Greg Ewing, and hopefully get Clyde Kersey here as a state representative in District 43. But with me right now is the current incumbent state senator, Tim Skinner, in District 38. Thanks for joining us here tonight.
You're welcome, Dan.
What has tonight been like for you so far?
Well, a bundle of nerves at this point. We've been watching the results coming in and got somebody at the courthouse catching them as soon as they post them up on the board. So got a slight lead right now in Vigo County, but I haven't heard. My phone went dead and haven't been able to contact anybody up north, so I have no idea what's going on up there.
And your opponent now is Bill Webster. He's kind of a first time running anything, and this is actually the first race you've had, the actual contested race, since you were elected back in 2002. What's that been like for you?
Well, I think it's good in a lot of ways, because it makes you get out and hit the road when you don't necessarily feel like it, and makes you work, makes you ask a lot of questions of constituents, and learn a little bit more about your district and see what's really bothering people.
I know Bill Webster is kind of from the Rosedale area, got a lot of ties there, kind of that northern part of your pretty sprawling district you have all the way up north. You had a big fundraising advantage, about five times more than Bill. Make you nervous, or do you think incumbent city name recognition will help you out in the end?
Well, I hope so, and I hope the job that we've done since we've been in the Senate will help too. I hope we've picked up some people that will support us because of the work that I do in the Senate. And, you know, Park County is a Republican county historically, and the numbers that we were looking at from 2002 tells me that he will probably win Park County and probably win Warren County. Vermilion County is Democrat, but he's worked hard up there as well as I have. And so, you know, you're nervous until the end result is on the board, you know, until all the votes are counted.
This is kind of a hard year for Democrats, hard year for a lot of different reasons. Are you worried about any anti-incumbent kind of backlash in any way like that?
Oh, yeah, I think that's always a concern, you know, when times are tough and people have options, you know, they need results, or they want results and expect results. And so it's, you know, you find out, I think, as an incumbent, whether or not you've done enough to develop some loyal supporters and keep the people within your own party on your side. And so, you know, the final tally will tell us that.
And quick question for you. If you're reelected, what's the first thing you're going to do and try to work on as you head back to Indianapolis?
Well, I think one of the things that concerns me the most is all of the education reform that's going to be coming down the pike from the governor's office and the state superintendent of public instruction. Being an educator myself, I've had a lot of educators out working for me in hopes that I will get reelected and be a spokesperson for education. And I think that's got to be right up there with trying to do whatever we can to create a climate to bring some jobs back into the state.
Good deal. Hey, Tim, thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate
it. Thank you.
Best of luck tonight.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we'll be back in a bit. Mark, back to you in the studio.